ईश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। अगजानन पद्मार्कं गजानन अहर्निशम् अनेकदन्तं भक्तानां एकदन्तं उपास्महे। एकदन्तं उपास्महे।
Now, phala shruti. Shruti means also means not only Vedas, shruti means not only shastras, but also when you chant the Vedas, when you do adhyayanam, when you contemplate, that also known as shruti. So when you do shruti, when you do adhyayanam, when you contemplate, when you study, when you recite, all these activities could be categorized under shruti. So phala shruti, what do you mean phala shruti means? Phala, fruit. What is a fruit? So you sow a seed and wait for the plant to come, the sapling comes, and you tend it to the, then you tend it to the plant, the sapling, and it goes into a tree and eventually the fruit comes out. It's not as well as you put the seed, the fruit comes out. So that's why the word phala is used. So whatever they are going to say here in the phala shruti is not going to happen like as soon as you sit one day and chant Ganapati Tadarshi or something. So, they have to learn it. So that is why the rishis give us the incentives, because they know that we human will not do anything just for the sake of God. If they tell you that moksha, you think most of it will do it? There is moksha, I don't even know what it is. But if they tell you, you know, this will improve your health, this will keep your children studying better, this will improve your home life, yes, most of it will take up to the practice. But that is how the rishis are so merciful, so kind, so loving, that by giving us a little incentive, they know where they are taking us. They are taking us to our final goal of moksha. But they know that if they tell us that you'll get moksha, most of us even may not even turn our face to Vishnu, so we'll turn away and walk the other way. So they are so compassionate, they are so kind, like you are kind to children, that you tell them to do this, but you know that that matter is not exactly the purpose, but you want to take them somewhere else, somewhere up higher. So the ultimate goal. So that's why you have them do every day little things here and there with the ultimate goal in mind. The same way the rishis did that to us. That the ultimate goal in mind, but I can't have this guy or this lady or this woman, this girl or this boy turn to me, because if I tell them moksha, they will go the other way. But if I tell them this and this, you'll do good in the studies, you'll do good in the job, there's in the chanting. But by chanting this, I know where they will go. So that's why the phala shruti's are there. And then primarily, like I said, it's in the form of material benefit, health, wealth, etc., but leading to spiritual happiness. And what is spiritual happiness as compared to material, terrestrial, temporal happiness? Spiritual happiness is a happiness that is permanent. Spiritual happiness is something that cannot be taken away. So even if your mind is troubled, if you're going through tsunamis in your life, if you're going through turbulence in your life, you pick up some of this mantra and chant them, they'll put you in a state of happiness. They do, believe me, they do. So you can pick up this mantra, whether it's a Kali mantra, a Shiva mantra, and you chant and you practice the Mahaganesh mantra. And then, so when you chant this, they'll put you in a state of happiness, in a state of joy. It's like, well, there's darkness, you bring a light in, and the darkness is gone. So that's how these mantras work. So that's how the spiritual happiness compared to material happiness. Material happiness is transitory. Spiritual happiness is Satchitananda. Satchitananda. So that place where nothing can be taken away. And before we go further, why the when the rishi say these things, all this benefit, they're not telling you your life. Why? Because they make the commitment right in the beginning that the Atharvani Rishi was giving us this undertaking that Rutan Lakshmi, Satyam Lakshmi, I'm telling you the truth, I'm telling you the ultimate reality, what is truth. And the difference between Rutan and Satyam, Satyam is ultimate reality, Brahma Satyam, that ultimate reality. Rutan is the obvious reality. When the sun is rising, the sun looks like it's traveling, but it's not really traveling. Satyam is sun is in one place, Rutan is sun is moving. And the other analogy I can give you is, there's light from the sun. We see the light from the sun. That is the Rutan. So what is the Satyam? The Satyam is, Yadatra Surya Vadi, the sun does not shine there. That is Satyam. Why do you say that? Because the Satyam is the sun does not shine. Yadatra Surya Vadi, the sun does not shine there. Neither the moon, nor the stars. Even the lightning doesn't shine there. What to talk about this little fire. So what is it talking about? That it is because of the Brahman. Because in the light of Brahman, all this is lit. Even though they look like they are shining, but the Satyam is, they are lit because of the light of Brahman. So that is the Satyam. The light of Brahman is the Satyam. And Rutam is that the light of the sun. So both are true. But ultimate Satyam is Satyam. So these are the first sutis. एतदर्वशीर्षम् योदीते स कर्मभूयाय कल्पते स सर्वविघ्नैश्च न बाध्यते. सो अधीतेरि एतत् अथर्वशीर्षम् ओवर् चैण्ट् अथर्वशीर्षम् ओवर् तत् अध्ययनम् अधीतेरि अध्ययनम् चैण्ट् स्टडीस् कान्टेम्प्लेट्स् आल् मीनिङ्ग् ओफ् टुगेदर् वर्ड् अध्ययनम् वेदाध्ययनम्. सो एतत् अथर्वशीर्षम् योदीते ओवर् जस्टिस् what happens, saha, that person, whether it's a man or a woman, dharma bhuyaya kalpate. The word kalpa of these, he becomes eligible, he becomes fit, kalpa, he becomes fit, kalpa is not a section of the Veda. He becomes fit, he becomes qualified to realizing Brahman, realizing the ultimate knowledge, because the Tathravashirisham, nothing but Vedanta, Latin is an Upanishad. So that's why they make this the highest climb here. Brahma Bhuyaya Kalpate, there's no other climb higher than this, because achieving the Brahma, knowledge of Brahma, that was ultimate achievement. Before they talk to you about material benefits, they show you the highest law. The Rishi is showing you that each other is, you ultimately can get there. Yes, you can get there. And how do you get there? Because not only because it's an Upanishad, because it's also associated with Lord Ganesha. Lord Ganesha will remove all obstacles. Sarva Vignai na Bhagyate. None of the obstacles will bind you. Bhagya means binding. So the obstacles cannot tie you down. They will not bind you down. And then, without the obstacles binding you down, you will get there. Yes, the Sattva Sinisham Yogi Te, Sattva Mahogaya. The material upsets in your material life, whether obstacles in your job, whether obstacles in your family life, may all will be gone, helping you onwards and upwards towards the final goal of realizing Brahman, being one with the Brahman. That is number one is the Palashuti. What is the second one? So Sarvatra Sukham Yedate. So on the way to realize the final goal after removing obstacles, you'll find all kinds of happiness. You'll find all kinds of happiness. And then what will also happen, your karma will be also neutralized. So sarvatra sutamedate, sapancha maha papa pramuchyate. The greatest sins, all the bad karma will be neutralized. So by Yetatatarvashirisham yogi, by doing adhyayanam, by doing contemplation, by studying atarvashirisham, this is what will happen, what will happen. Brahma bhuyaya kalpate, sa sarva vignayana bhagyate, sa sarva sukamedate, sa parya maha bhava kamuchyate. So how many are there so far? One is brahma bhuyaya kalpate, number two, vigna bhagyate, number three, sukamedate, number four, karma neutralized, pancha maha bhava. Pramuchyate, and there is more to come. Now, what are the Panchamahapapas? This is again from the scriptures. Sneham Krutva, Surambitva, Bhutva, Api, Guru Dharakaha. You know, when you betray your Guru, when you do Brahmahatya, when you do alcoholic drinks, when you steal gold, So all these are being judged with any of the people who do this. These are called the Panchamahapapas. According to Manu, these are the Panchamahapapas. So if you have done that in our previous life, you don't know what we did in our previous life to be here. So that we don't know. So the Buddha Rishi tells us that the Panchamahapapas should be released from those in case you did all those things. Then we're moving on, he also tells you, every day today, what will happen day today? సాయమీరాగో దివసకృతం పాపం నాశయతి. ఎందు అధ్యయనం ఇన్ ద ఈవినింగ్ వాట్ ఎవర్ యువర్ అన్బికమింగ్ డీడ్, వాట్ ఎవర్ యువర్ థింగ్స్ దట్ యువర్ నాట్ లైఫ్ సపోర్టింగ్, దోస్ కర్మ గెట్ న్యూట్రలైజ్. సాయ వెన్ యూ డూ ఇన్ ఈవినింగ్ టూ, వెన్ యూ డూ యువర్ గణపతి ఎక్స్పెషన్స్ ఇన్ చాంటింగ్ ఈవినింగ్, యువర్ కర్మస్, యువర్ బ్యాడ్ కర్మస్ డన్ ఇన్ ద డే టైమ్ గెట్ న్యూట్రలైజ్. When you do in the morning, rather at the end, the bad karma, then in the night that you utilize. So when you do both times, Sayam Pratha Prayinjano Papo Apapo Bhavati, your sin becomes your sin. Papo means sins, Apapo means no sin. Papo Apapo. So Papo, what it becomes? Apapo. So sins become no sin. Sayamadhiyano Devatakaram Papam Nashayati, Pratha Radhiyano Rathikatam Papam Nashayati. Doing both times, I am brought up by Injana, Papa, 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 Bhavati, and then Sarvatriyadiyana. When you do it all the time under all circumstances, Sarvatriyadiyana means when you do it all the time under all circumstances, Parijnuva Bhavati, there are no more obstacles, and then what happens? When there are no more obstacles, then you achieve all the Purushattas, four Purushattas in life, Dharma, Artha, Kama, Moksha, and Cha, meaning the tea. So this is what the Rishi is telling us. సో సాయం ఉదయం దివసకృతం, రాత్రి ఉదయం రాత్రి కృతం, సాయం ప్రాత ప్రయోజనం పాపం సర్వక్రాది ధర్మార్థ కామ మోక్షం చ విందతి. Because I told you all this, that atam section will do this, will do this, just then don't give it to anybody. Itam atarvashyasam ashishyayana deyam. Ashishyayana means no disciple. No disciple means one who is not qualified to be a disciple. So, Sishya and no Sishya. A Sishya means one is not qualified to be a disciple. So because of greed and because of whatever reason, if you give it to somebody who doesn't deserve, then you incur the sin. Yoyadi moha dasyati ta papiyan bhavati. So when you do the route of moha, you become such a sinner. Okay, because according to the Guru, even if you commit this kind of sin, even Atharva Shetam, then I doubt you for an Atharva Shetam is telling you not to do it. Okay, now, if you do this 1,000 times, Sahasra Vartana, if you do 1,000 hours, Sahasra Vartana, Yanyan Kama Madhite, Yanyan, whatever you desire, all the rightful desire, all the rightful desire, Tam Tam Anena Sadaya, Yanyan Kama Madhite, Tam Tam Anena Sadaya.
Now, in the next part of the Phalashruti, the Rishi understands that it may be difficult and sometimes not even possible to do 1,000 times the Ganapati Atharvashirism. So he gives you another easy way to please Lord Ganesha, and that is to do Abhishekam. So that's in the next part of the Phalashruti, where he says, Anena Ganapatim Abhisinchati Sabhagmi Bhavati. Anena, with this Ganapati Atharvashirism, whoever does Abhishekam to Lord Ganesha, Abhishekam being pouring water and along with the other dravyas like milk, yogurt, and ghee, and then honey, and sugar, and fruit juice, and tender coconut juice. So these are all Abhisheka dravyas, which we do here in our temple for every Sankatahara Chaturthi. So Anena Ganapatim Abhisinchati. So when you do Abhishekam to Lord Ganesha with Atharva Shirsha Mantra. By the way, when we do it here at our temple, Sankatahara Chaturthi, we chant 11 times Ganapati Atharva Shirsham while the devotees, each and every one of the devotees who is here, comes and does the Abhishekam himself or herself to Lord Ganesha, and also along with the Durvangurai, along with the tender Durva grass, put tender Durva grass on Ganesha, and then do Abhishekam while chanting Ganapati Atharvashirisam. So the Phalashruti says here that Anena Ganapatim Abhisinchati Savagni Bhavati, whoever does Abhishekam to Ganesha, with this Ganapati Atharvashirsa mantra becomes Vagmi. What is a Vagmi? A well-spoken, talented writer and a speaker. And then after that, what is the fal for doing or praying and chanting this Ganapati Atharvashirsam during the Chaturthi? Chaturthya manashnanchapati savidyavan bhavati ityatarvana vakyam. Chaturthi.
Shukla Chaturthi. The Krishna Chaturthi comes after the full moon, which is also called Shankara Chaturthi, which is a special day. Another Chaturthi comes after the new moon, that is the Shukla Paksha Chaturthi. So these Shukla Paksha and the Krishna Paksha Chaturthi is a great opportunity for us. Why? Because if you do little fasting on those days, Anashna means fasting. Chaturthya means on those Chaturthi days, Anashna, by observing a little fast, if you chant this Ganapati Atharvashirsam, you become knower, the Vidyavan Bhavati. And you have to remember that the Rishi makes it a point to tell you that this is my word, take my word. Chakarvana Vakyam. If you do this on Chaturthi, Anashna, by observing a little fast, you become Vidyavan, you become a knower. What kind of knower? You're a knower of physics or taste, you know. You become a knower of that ultimate knowledge, knowing which nothing else should be known, understanding which nothing else needs to be understood. But that kind of Vidyavan you become. When you do on Chaturthi, Anashna, by observing a little fast, you do Chaturthi, and the Rishi gives you, makes it a point to tell you that this is my word, this is my guarantee. The Atharvana Vakyam, this is the word of Atharvana Rishi. Brahmadhyā varanam nitya no viveti kadāchan. Brahmadhyā āvaranam. Āvaranam means covering. When we do Sakti Upasana, we do Navāvarana Puja. In Kamakshi temple, in Kamchipuram, Navāvarana Puja goes for like 9-10 hours. Great pujas. Navāvarana means that you move from the outer cover, outer shielding, into the inner bindu. So from one fortress to the other fortress, Navavana. So Brahma Dhyavana, but the ultimate knowledge, Brahma is hidden in so many layers. So if you ever one of you are familiar with Ramalinga Swami, who was a great saint who melted his body into pure glass just barely 450 years ago. And if you ever go through his place in Siddhivalagam, near Vadalu, they will have the seventh green. And so beyond the seventh green is the ultimate knowledge. So this is called the Avarana. So the Atharvana Rishi is telling you, Brahmadhyā Avarana Vidyā Navigati Kadāchanati. So you will, all your coverings will be removed and you will gain the knowledge of the first layer, the primary layer, Brahman itself. When you understand Brahma Vidyā, and there is no, and then once you understand Brahma Vidyā, you don't have to be afraid of anything. There is no bhaya. Which means vidayati kadachaneti. Never ever. Kadachaneti means never ever you'll be afraid of anything. So, once again that knowledge, Brahmadhyā varanam, the primary covering, the primary manifestation, so you'll gain that knowledge when you do all this on a Chaturthi, observing little fasting, when you chant Ganapati Atharvashirsam a few times. So all this will happen to you. And, you never be afraid of anything, including death. Even Yama would be afraid of. Then the Rishi gives us some very practical suggestions, very practical things, very easy technology. Not very hard one, easy for everyone to do. Nurvangurai. Nurvangurai is a special grass used for Ganesha worship. Most of you are from India, but you know what that is. So your Nurvangurai yadati. So when you worship Ganesha with the Nurva grass, Nurva Ankur, Ankur means bud. Nurva Ankur means with the buds of the grass, means that when you take the grass, there are a lot of buds in it. So where the branches come out, so that's why it's called Nurva Ankura. So the Nurva Ankura, everything means worship. Whatever it is, but simply worship. So when you worship Ganesha with that, you become Vaishvarana. Vaishvara means to become prosperous like Kubera. So these are the material incentives that the Rishi gives us. So if you remember, those of you come to our temple, You know, at the end of the puja, Raja Viraja Yaprasaya Tagile Edmo Vaishyavanaya Purmuhe Vaishyavanaya Purmuhe Not Nayo Pramo Vayam Vai. So the Vai got separated from the mantra. So Vaishyavanaya Purmuhe The Vaishyavanaya is the Kubera. Who worships Ganapati with the tender grass, becomes first with light? Kubera. And then, the offering is very simple. He can get the grass, but he can get his mantra, which is popular, which is so easy. So, talking about mantra, all of you from India, you know that is what part of a wedding ritual we call Lajahom. Lajahom, where the, yeah, all of you are familiar with that, Lajahom, where the bride and the groom offer, offerings in the fire. So that's called Lajahom, part of a wedding ritual. Because they want prosperity, they want well-being. But that is all inculcated in every aspect of Indian ritual. So here the Rishi tells you, your large area. So when you worship Lord Ganesha from pride, you become your Shovan. You become a very accomplished person. And then not only become an accomplished person, you become Medawan. You become a knower. You become a knower of that knowledge, your knowledge. Anything else needs to be known. Your larger intention, one for this, Mela one for this. And then if you have the time and if you have the proof of ladies that you can make this, like you can make, we did it one time here in our temple, thousand modakas. So if you can do our week heaven to Lord Ganesha with 1,000 modakas, a couple of people can get together, a few people, a few families, can make modakas, so everybody makes 100 or a couple of hundred. In the Ardhaya, we can do this at your place if you're interested. So organize it and I'll be there. I'll be more than happy to come there and do this for you. So, we can do 1,000 modaka. Yo modaka sarasvene anything. The avanchita palamavapno. Whatever desires that you rightful desires you desire, you will get accomplished those results. So this is again, palapala shruti. Yo modaka sarasvene anything. Modaka is very dear to Lord. Then we shan. Sahavanchita palamavapno. And then if you do simple harvest with ghee and the summit, the sajya summit, summit is summit, the word sajya, sajya is siddhi, sajya summit, yajati, when you worship Ganesha with ajya and the little tray, sarvam lavate, you attend everything, and the Rishi repeats himself, sarvam lavate, sarvam lavate, he or she attends everything, the prayer that she is asking for. And then, Astra Brahmanan Samya Grahitva Sutya Vachasmi Bhavati. Brahman is not by birth, Brahman is by the deed, what you do. So with those kind of people, like-minded people who are in quest of Brahman, so if you do satsang with them, and they chant Atharvashayasam, you become Surya Vachasmi. Surya Vachasmi means you become tejas, you become splendor, you become whiter. So Surya Vachasmi. So when you do this with being a satsang in a group, because doing in a new group makes it even more powerful. That's why every Sankarahara Chaturthi, we do it in a group and we repeat Ganapati Atharvashayasam 11 times. Because we chant not only for Chaturthi Day, because it's also a special Chaturthi Day, it's called Sankarahara Chaturthi Day. And we also not only chant 11 times, while chanting 11 times, we also do Abhishekam to Ganapati's beautiful murti that we have here. So all that is mentioned as much as possible, we try to fulfill here in the temple. Surya Grahe, this is beautiful one, where we did all those here one time. Surya Grahe, Mahasatya, Pratima, Sanyedavva, that class of them probably. The Rishi is talking about four things here. One is he's talking about Surya Grahe, which is solar eclipse, and Mahanadi, any river or ocean. So, on a day of solar eclipse, near a river or an ocean. Then what else he wants? He wants a murti of Ganesha. If an idol of Ganesha, whether it's copper or bronze or brass or panchaloka, an idol of Ganesha or stone. So murti. That is pratima. So Surya Grahe, Mahanadiyam, so by the what source, or a lake, pratima sannidhau, in the nearness sannidhau, and then what's the fourth thing? We chant. Japa. So when you do this, what happens? You obtain mantra siddhi. You don't have to do prascharana, look to mantra siddhi. So to get a mantra siddhi of any mantra, you have to do prascharana. But in this case, no. The Rishi gives you a very easy upaya, very easy technology. That Surya Grahe, Mahanadhyam, Pratima Sannidham, by chanting it, you become mantra siddhi. And it's almost impossible to do prascharana for Atharvashesu because there are so many mantras in that. So Surya Grahe, Mahanadhyam, Pratima Sannidham, what the block? Now, Mahavignaha Pramuchyate, you get free from the greatest of obstacles. Mahadoshaha Pramuchyate, from the greatest of the doshas. Whatever doshas there is. Mahavignaha Pramuchyate, Mahadoshaha Pramuchyate, the greatest papa. Mahapapa Pramuchyate. And the last one is the most important. Mahapratyavaya Pramuchyate. So this is the ultimate disaster. What is the ultimate disaster? You drown in the disasters of life. So if you speak that word, Mahapratyavaya, Pratyavaya, Prati means going towards anything, avaya means drowning. So even in a situation as worth as drowning, what do you mean, Rishi? You are drowning in the ocean of Sansara. You are drowning in the ocean of the river of Sansara. You are drowning in the troubles, the turmoil of Sansara. So under those circumstances, what will uplift you is this Ganapati Atharvashesham. Will uplift you from Mahavigna, uplift you from Mahadosha, will uplift you from Mahapapa, and uplift you from the ultimate drowning situation. Then, Satarabhavit Bhavati Satarabhavit Bhavati, after relief, after saving you, relieving you from all the trouble, then it becomes and knower of that ultimate knowledge. Because you have to be relieved of all obstacles. You have to overcome all these obstacles to know that ultimate knowledge. Then you become a knower of that ultimate knowledge. And this is the word of the Veda, Yayam Veda, and this is the Upanishad. And then you say, Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. When you're talking about Shanti, the three kinds of Shanti, from your troubles, from all the Gautika trouble, or Dailika trouble, or Jatika trouble, we'll talk about some other time. So you get free from all this God trouble that is coming from all these three sources, Adi Gautika, Adi Dailika, and Adi Gautika. Thank you very much, and then now we will have question time. Any questions, please?
Thank you so much, sir.
And thanks to Shantiji, who authored all these ideas, Shanti Mati Gunta, and Kumarji, who made it practical. So we have to thank them because for their idea and Kumarji's effort to make this a reality, this would not have happened.
Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwarah, Guru Sakshat Parabrahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave.